Next up, I'd like to show you two new features of MFM2, Transient Balance and the Diffuser Effect. Both are very interesting tools for shaping the transients of your signal. We'll create a simple but effective preset to showcase these two features. This Hive 2 arpeggio is playing in a loop. It's dry, and I want some fast rhythmical delays to cascade around the arpeggio and give it some more momentum and depth. Here, in this instance of MFM2, I'll start with a blank slate by right-clicking on the data display and selecting Init. Let's turn up the wet level so we can hear what we're doing. Next, I'll shut down the outputs of delay lines 3 and 4 to make it easier to follow the first two delay lines. I'll set the pan positions for delay 1 and delay 2 slightly left and right. Delay 1 gets a bass sync of a 1/32nd note, while delay 2 gets a dotted 16th note. Let's change the feedback mode to quad ping pong. We've just laid down the rhythmic foundation for our delay patch. Now, let's look at a new feature in the input section, the transient balance. Turning the knob up lets you emphasize any transients in your wet signal. In our case, we're bringing up the percussive attack of our Hive arpeggio. As we turn the knob all the way up, the non-transient portion of the wet signal almost vanishes, whilst the clicky portion of the sound becomes much more prominent. Setting values below the zero position has the reverse effect. The transients are now being reduced. And as we turn the knob further, we're left with a sound that's lost most of its percussive attack. Let's bring it up again. Without overdoing it, we'll exaggerate the transients in our arpeggio. I'll now let delay lines 3 and 4 join the game. Panned hard left and hard right. Delay 3 gets a dotted 1/8th note, whilst delay 4 will create dotted 1/4 notes. This time, let's soften the transients by turning the transient balance control down a little. This creates the illusion of the signal being slightly more distant. Let's take a closer look at the new diffuser effect and what it can do for our signal. Clicking on the effect selector for delay 1 and delay 2 brings up a choice of effects algorithms. Pick diffuser, and you'll be greeted by a wave of grungy, early 80s digital ambience. Let's slightly reduce the size. But we won't stop there. In the bottom right, you'll find the modulation matrix, where you can patch up to 4 modulation routings between various sources and targets. Clicking on the source selector opens a drop-down list with various modulation sources. We'll go with LFO1 here. Click on the target selector and drag the red line with the crosshair to your modulation target, the diffuser size parameter. And then simply dial in the desired modulation amount. We're now hearing a pretty wild LFO modulation of the size parameter. Let's tame it. Switch to the LFO tab and pick random hold for the waveform, resulting in a staircase wave of random amplitudes. I'll set it to sync to 1/16th notes. The LFO now puts out 2 new values for the diffuser size every 16th note. Nice. Let's add another twist by modulating the master feedback. In modulation matrix slot 2, pick LFO2 for the source. Connect the target selector with the master feedback knob. Turn up the modulation depth knob. In this case, I'll go all the way here. Let's switch over to the LFO tab and tweak that LFO2. Select Saw Up for the waveform. Now, in the Restart menu, pick Gate. The LFO will now restart with every new note, just like an envelope. Tweak the LFO rate until you hit that sweet spot. As you've seen, we've come up with a cool delay patch in a matter of minutes. Don't miss our other videos on More Feedback Machine, and see you around.